and the news editor said to me, "Jeremy, go into reception, there's a bloke there who reckons he's Jesus. Just get rid of him." Now, I know what you're thinking, that's a terrible highlight. The news editor's from Birmingham. People could travel even in the 80s. So I said, what's happening? There's a bloke in reception, he thinks he's Jesus, he's got some sort of a statement. So I said, oh, okay. So I wandered into reception. There's three people there. A young woman with a baby, an old woman with a headscarf, and a tall man with long hair and a beard wearing white robes. Over his arm he had an anorak, a very modern day anorak. Didn't quite fit the biblical look, but I still thought, that's probably Jesus. So I wandered up to him and I said, "Oh, hello, I'm from the newsroom, I believe you've got a statement for me." And he grabbed me like that, round the throat, spun me round, and from underneath the anorak shot something hard and metallic into my back and said, "Take me through to the studio now, I've got a machine gun." Now, I need to just stop at this point and tell you all my stories are not true, which is why some of them do have quite disappointing endings. I would have written a much better ending to this story if I'd made it up. Okay, so I'm like this, Jesus, machine gun, and right. So I thought, I'll take him through to the studio. So he marched me through like that. I thought the receptionist will be calling the police. She's not even looking. Get into the Meet Morning On Air studio, program being presented by Tim Gibson. Tim Gibson! Nobody? Okay. So, I walked in, and Tim goes, "Oh, Jeremy, there's music playing." And I said, "This man's got a gun and he's going to shoot me if you don't read out this statement." And Tim had his headphones really loud. And he just went, "You what?" I thought, "I'm going to be killed. Because Tim's got his headphones too loud." So I said, "This man's got a gun and he's going to shoot me and you." So I thought, if I involved him, if you don't read out this statement. So he said, "Oh, okay. Interrupt this record." It was very hard in real life, but on air he had that voice that all local radio presenters have. "Interrupt this record because we've got a listener in the studio. Always lovely to meet the listeners. This one has got a statement and he wants me to read it out. Delighted to do that, of course. And he goes like this. I am Jesus. I am the Messiah. I am the truth."